Is the grass seed in your yard genetically modified? Do you know if it is or not? Ah, see? Now, if you've been listening to the show about a month ago, I think, we had a wonderful conversation where we had dozens, literally, of people weighing in, and I asked a simple question. Where are all the grasshoppers? You see where I'm going? People are nodding their head in the other room. Here's what I'm thinking. Now, I don't know this to be true. I'm not a scientist. This is just kind of something that's running through my mind, but I want to throw it out there and see what you think. Since genetically modified grass has now killed cattle, a cow is very, very big. I don't know if you've ever seen a cow, but it's big. And it's because of the genetically modified structure of this grass. I don't know if it was because the grass went through a drought and started breaking down in a different way. I don't know, instead of releasing oxygen into the air, it started releasing cyanide. I don't know how it worked. I mean, they're going to have to examine this for a while. But let's say it is a genetically modified organism, and there's this built-in defect associated with it. What happens if it's in your yard? We've been looking at a lot of things for the causes of a lot of things. When the rise of ADHD started happening, we started looking at, well, is it sugar? And I'm not saying sugar is good. Sugar is obviously bad, but think about this for a second. We've been using sugar in mass since the 50s. We didn't see a rise in ADHD until the early 90s. We've also seen a rise in autism, and we've been thinking, well, is it vaccines? Is it the processed food? And obviously, I'm not saying those are good or bad. But what I'm saying is, and again, this is just speculation. I'm not accusing anybody or any company. But what if it's in the grass? Did we even think about looking in our own front yard? And I don't want to be an alarmist because, like I said, I really don't know. But I want to look into this further. Because if it is in the grass, think about the timing. When did GMO really start to become prevalent? Early to mid-90s. When did we see an insane rise in ADHD and autism and all these other sort of effects on children? Yeah, exactly. Now, is that just coincidental? Or is the fact that we've become a genetically modified yard owner play into that? And we did it without even suspecting it. Now, if that's the case, is the grasshopper acting like the canary down the mine shaft? Miners used to carry a canary down in the mine shaft, and if, you know, everything was going bad, the little canary would die before the men would die, so the men would know, hey, let's get the bleep out of here quick. And I don't know, maybe you see grasshoppers where you live, but when we asked that question, it was absolutely amazing how many people started coming out and saying, you know what, you're absolutely right. Now that you say that, I haven't seen a grasshopper in 5 years. I haven't seen very many lightning bugs either. Yeah, there's still a few, but not many. People were saying, yeah, what happened to the moths now that I think about it, Josh? Josh, I don't hear crickets around my house like I used to either. And nobody, including myself, nobody thought it was actually the grass. But think about this, okay? Let's continue down this rabbit hole. Roundup. We have grass seed that's Roundup ready, right? Who makes Roundup?